Well, here we are again. Follow me to Apex, my friends. Reaper Hunter 23 here. Oh, it's really loud. Welcoming you back to Let's Play Plants vs. Zombies. Last time my recording session got cut a little short because I ordered a pizza and arrived. So we're gonna pick up. Basically, Crazy Dave gave me $1,000. And that was long and short of that. And we got a split pea, which shoots back and forwards. Or which will shoot forwards and backwards. It's really helpful for these here digger zombies. Let's see here. Throw down the blower. And walnut. Alright. Almost done with our sunflowers here. Let's see, put a little seed from right there. Oh, whoops. No. Oh. Simple solution. Oh, it's still ate it. Okay. Yeah, that's. Puzzle mode unlocked. Play it from the main menu. You don't mind if I do. Oh, that's kind of nice. Must be back there. Oh yeah, I forgot that's what they do. They go from the back. I thought they just walk straight onto your. Or straight into your house, which would be infuriating, to be honest. Because that'd be so hard to prepare for. But since I'm here. Done already. I honestly, it's shocking that those things move so slow that the repeater half of my like some bad news over on the poolside front here. That's all that's left though, so. Oh. This one, this is an interesting one. The starfruit shoots stars in 5 directions. So it's really weird, just because it shoots backwards. Like, really, it's best to just throw this in like the middle of something. I'm sorry, I was taking a drink. It's best to just throw it in like the middle of something, because let's see if I can get through a sentence without needing a drink here. Because that would be the most coverage, right? But it's strange, really. Alright, I'm gonna forgo trying to deal with the fog, since there's no I don't have any balloon guys, so I don't really care about using the blower. I'll just wing it like I usually do. Oh yeah, the fog gets more aggressive the further on you get too, and I forgot that up until now. Oh well.
The zombies are coming.
I'm drinking one of those Kool-Aid bursts. Those little plastic bottle Kool-Aid things. Throwback to when I was a little kid and got those in my, like, after soccer game snack bags, huh? Alright, I found where the one of them is. Yeah. Probably plant the next one a little further back. Braids. I love that sound clip so much. Alright, got that one. That one's all sorted out. We're gonna throw him up there. Uh-oh. Bad news there. Throw a walnut on this guy, so we can, See, as long as you're kinda clever, you can make almost anything work, just even with half of it being, you know, shots in the dark. Oh man, he really went at that thing, though. I think I heard something under the water. I guess I'll just start planting puff shrooms as far as I can get them out. I'll throw a star fruit like right here. Should be able to help with just a little bit of damage either way here. Throw another one like right there. Thank you. Let it be known, while I may not have my entire screen full, I have almost all of my visible screen full. I was gonna try and, you know, just choose A side, but I realized I don't really need to do that one. Just throw him in the middle of the screen. Every time I did that, I think I pretty much handled the large wave there, although there's really no way to tell. Oh, I don't even have a squash, I'm silly. Throw down a walnut in front of that bucket head. Throw a split pea here. Throw it there. It's funny because the starfruit will just fire all five of its little appendages wherever it feels like, rather than choosing one to shoot from, like the one that's relevant, which is amusing. I think I just planted a walnut in front of another walnut. I really don't know what happened over there. Thing sprung in the middle of the fog, like a thief in the night. I'm gonna unplant that upstream mushroom as soon as I get the chance. Alright, there we go. Letting some sun fade like a silly goose. That was my computer that made that noise, not yours. Throw down another split pea, I guess. I was about to doom shroom, or unplant my star fruit, and throw a doom shroom there just to stop that guy where you stop him cold, but it seems a little excessive. Alright, so I got something somewhere, somehow. As soon as it recharges, I'm all over another one, though. Oh, I thought I got this in the next world. Pumpkin protects plants that are within its shell. So, this is like a walnut, except you can put it on a specific plant. Oh, really? Oh, Pogo guys, I thought they didn't show up until later either. Whatever. I don't remember how to deal with them. I don't have any digger tools, so I'm going to forgo using a split pea this time. We got any balloon jerks? No? Alright. So we have a pumpkin, which means we might not need a walnut. Huh. also in a doom shroom. Let's not forget our sunflower. Let's see, what else do we... What else would we like here? Huh. Now, just in case, because... I've totally not used the tall nuts this whole time, because... they're expensive. I'm also fairly certain that pogo sticks can jump over the tall nuts. That better. Some of the juice from my drink dripped onto my hand. Oh, sunflower. Duh. Ah! No, sunflower. This guy. I don't remember. I don't remember how to... I don't remember what to do against him. I guess Doom Shroom. Alright, so... Just for example, I'm gonna put a pumpkin on that. And if they ever get that far... I'll show you what happens. You'll get to see what happens. Maybe I should have put it on one of the ones in the middle instead. But, you know. One of the ones where something was actually happening. Alright, pumpkin should be recharged. Oh, well, zombie's gonna be dead. Never mind. Put a pumpkin on that one. I'm pretty sure he's eating mushroom.